Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be discussing another topic. This is part 2 of naming hydrocarbons. So this time I'll be discussing about how to name hydrocarbons if that hydrocarbon is an alkenes. Okay, just like I have said last time in my video about naming alkanes, the rules we use in naming alkanes will also be used in naming the alkenes, okay? Alkenes. Eto alkenes, it's because of the double bond. Okay? Now, the only thing is, we also need to know or we need to base also our answer dun sa pagka-count natin doon sa part where we locate or we can find the double bond. Okay, so yung the smallest number where the double bond is located, that will be our basis kung saan yung naming. But then of course, just like what we're doing in naming alkanes, we also need to know the longest continuous chain. So dito, since diretso lang naman siya, so ang longest continuous chain natin dito, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 siya. Okay? And that is butte. Okay? But this time, we have to also base where does double bond is located. So, saan makikita ang double bond? Dito. Okay? Etong part na to. So, nandito ang double bond. So, if we try to name this, or we count, para malaman natin kung ang name dito, dito tayo mag-start. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Bakit tayo dito nag-start? Nag-start tayo dito, it's because nandirito yung double bond natin. So, yung nearest number or yung smallest number where the double bond is located, dun tayo mag-start. Okay? After we count the longest chain. So, since yung double bond ay makikita natin sa pinaka-first as we count 1, 2, 3, 4, we are going to write 1 here. 1, and then dash. Since may apat tayong carbon, we are going to name this as 1-butene. Okay, it's not butane, but it's butene. Why? Because we are dealing with alkenes already. Okay, alkenes because may double bond. At yung 1 dito magsasabi kung saan natin makikita yung double bond. At ng double bond ay nandito sa first. So, 1-butene. Okay, next, it's here. The next one, so first, titingnan natin ang longest chain natin. So, saan ang longest chain? Pwede tayo mag-start dito. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pag dito naman, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, parehong 5 siya. Ngayon, ang basis na natin, after nating tingnan kung saan yung longest chain natin, is titingnan din natin kung saan makikita yung pinaka smallest number ng double bond. So, saan ang double bond? Nandirito yung double bond. Okay? So, since nandirito yung double bond, hindi tayo pwede mag-start dito. But, instead, mag-start tayo dito kasi 1, 2. Pag dito kasi tayo nag-start, that will be 1, 2, 3. So, 3 yung double bond. So, dapat dito. So, start tayo dito. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So, now that we know kung saan makikita yung double bond, we also need to identify the branching or yung substituent natin. Okay? So, yung substituent natin dito, it's a methyl. At dahil methyl yon, so how are we going to name this? So first, isusulat natin kung saan makikita yung substituent, which is on the second. So this is 2-methyl. Next, after that, we also need to write where we can locate the double bond, which is on the second also. So susulat din natin dito ng 2-1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At dahil 5, siya ay pentene. Okay? So, it will be 2-methyl, 2-pentene. Okay, pentene dahil double bond. At 2-methyl dahil may branch out tayong 2 dito. At 2-pentene dahil yung double bond natin ay nasa second or nasa number 2 ng longest chain. Okay, next is the last part, which is this one. So again, dito kailangan longest chain ang hahanapin natin. So let's count from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Dahil wala namang ibang branch out dyan, so 7, ito yung longest chain natin. Next, after we know that ang longest chain natin is 7, next we need to find where we can find the double bond. At ang double bond natin ay nandirito. Okay, so nandito ang double bond. So since nandito yung double bond natin, ano ang ating gagawin? The next is, we are going to start the counting from here. Kasi ito yung pinakamalapit sa double bond. So, ang start natin ng counting is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay? So, ito yung double bond natin. Dito tayo nag-start. Kasi yan yung pinakamalapit. This is the smallest number where we can find the double bond. It can't be there. Okay? So, this time, it's not the substituent as our basis. Diba doon sa alkane kanina, ang basis natin ay yung branch out natin kung saan yung pinaka smallest number ng branch out. Ngayon, it's not the branch out, but where the double bond is located. So, if we're going to name this, this will be, this is 2, and this is 4, and this is 6, right? So, we are going to write this as yung chlorine natin. So, kailangan alphabetical order sa. So, yung chlorine natin, this will be what? 4. Since chlorine, just as I have said dun sa last video natin, pag mga halogen, we don't write it with the name chlorine, but instead we end it with 0. So this will be 4 chloro. Next, we also have another branch out, which is the nitrate, or the this one, the nitrogen dioxide. So instead of writing this as nitrite, we are going to write this as nitro. So this will be 4 chloro, 6 nitro. Next is 2 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so 2-heptene. Okay, so 4 chloro 6 nitro 2-heptene, this is the name of our hydrocarbon. So 4 chloro because yung chloro, yung chlorine dito ay makikita dito sa fourth carbon. 6 nitro, it's because it's on the 6. And 2 heptene because 2 indicates where the double bond is located. At nakikita siya dito sa second carbon. Okay, so that's how we write the nomenclature, or we write the name of the hydrocarbon alkenes. Okay, so I hope you learned something today. Again, this is Teacher Luis, your mommy tutor. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and always click the notification bell para mas maging updated kayo sa mga iba ko pang videos. Bye! Thank you!